Hello everybody and welcome back to Knaves Wealth Farm Extended. So yesterday, created a bit of an uproar I think when I said we were going to sell the 7810. That was the initial plan, but now we're not going to at all because this is clearly a bad decision. We're going to keep every tractor and add to the fleet. Some of you will hate that idea because we'll have too many tractors, but I'm just sort of at risk of upsetting too many people here. So this tractor is staying, we'll still use it. I'm going to replace it with this, the Case Optum 300 CVX. It's a good looking tractor. It's also very high horsepower. So this is going to be probably our flagship tractor. I'm going to use it today to do some baling because we need to bale field number 78. So a great opportunity for it. Now I do want to thank the modder for this because it is so good. And obviously the link will be below to promote it. Hopefully the link below is the original download link. I hate providing non-original download links because it doesn't help the modder at all. But it should be, hopefully. So, we can register it to Daggerwin if we want to. Shall we? Yeah, we might as well. Just go backwards. Gotta be really quick there because this can take forever if you dither. A W and finally an N. Where is N? There it is. Daggerwin. It's missing an I, but what can you do? Yes, this is the registration town, I believe. All of which are in continental Europe. Let's go with Bremen. There we go. Yes, that looks good. So, yeah, let's go and do a bit of baling. Looking forward to this. So from in the cab view, clearly, very highly detailed. It does have IC as well. The blind, very nice feature. The sunroof. Close it again, and then you've got a... I think that actually blocks out the light. Yes, it does. So it's kind of like a solid roof then. What do we have down here? The steering column. You can move it away, so when you jump out of the cab, it's not in your way so much. There we go, doors. Left door. Ooh, armrest. An articulating armrest. Very fancy. Over this side. Oh, wow. Lots of stuff. What's that done? Whoa, look at that. I suppose that would be. What would that be for? Forestry. Like an extra royal cage, yeah, and a grill on the back. Yeah, I would say it's probably for forestry. Just here we've got. Something. It could be the front linkage. Yes, it is. Front linkage just there. Obviously today we won't be using it, but it's good to see that you can fold this up. Nothing down the back here. So next one is this one just here. That is for the bonnet. There we go. And it's very detailed. Look at that. That is so good. Should probably jump out and take a closer look. It's got all the radiator in the front, the coolers, all the hoses and everything. Looks very good. I have actually increased the graphic setting today to make it a bit better. And two more. This one here is for the mudguards or the fenders, whatever you want to call them. I tend to call them mudguards. And this one here might take me a few minutes just to work it out because never used it before. We'll come back to it. This one here is for the warning panels for the dual wheels. This one here is for something else. Some of them you can't actually work out, but they all have a use. And that is for the back window. One of them, there we go, it's working now. This one is for the pin hitch on the back. There we go. Can just about see it going from down there. There we go. The other one I missed was this one just here. Back wheel weights. Oh yes, we've got the wheel weights in here. So there we go. That is the in-depth Daggerwin look at the Optum 300 CVX. Obviously it was a very brief one, but still, very good. So the true test is going to be when we actually come to bale, which is going to be right now, because we can't just sit around all day. This is going to be good. Now, luckily, the baler is already at the other yard, so we don't have to go out of our way to get to it. Oh, you can feel the power. You can tell it's a big tractor just because of the size of the fuel tank. Obviously, the bigger the tractor, generally, the bigger the fuel tank. It's got 629 litres. Incredible. So how fast can we go? 31, it reckons. Sounds about right for this. It's not always about the speed, though. It's about the horsepower. So nice. Right, I think it's here we need to go. I've done this trip so many times and still getting lost. So what we need to do is we need to bale that field just there. First of all, we need to row it up, of course. Mustn't forget that. But that's okay, so we've got the John Deere here. The baler is just in there. I think, actually, yeah, we'll just put this out of the way to start off with, just briefly. We are going to use it, without a doubt. But yeah, we just need to use the John Deere to row it up. Right, so I've had to drive all the way back again. We could have actually just picked this up before, but not to worry. The windrower is just here. So we'll have to get this attached. Oh, it's moved. Must have knocked it with something. So we'll put that on there. And we'll put the PTO on. Mustn't forget the PTO. And we'll head back over to the other yard and get this done. Because the sooner we get it done, the sooner we get to use the case. And this has been long awaited. So if you still didn't know, we're actually going to be doing hay bales today. We've done most of the work already in a previous episode. We've cut the field, we've tedded it, and the final job is just to rake it up and bale it. My favourite part, to be honest. So yeah, this should be quite an enjoyable episode. We do also need to do some maize harvesting, but that won't be in the near future. It'll probably be in a few weeks, or maybe 2 weeks actually. Within 2 weeks, I would say. Because we've still got some of the odd jobs to do. But definitely, before we finish this series, we will be doing a maize harvest. Now, I haven't yet decided whether or not we're going to continue the FS15 series into the release time of FS17. I'm not sure. I might do, like, once a week or something. But usually, when a new game is released, I sort of find it hard to go back to a previous version. Because you always want to be, well, I always want to be on the latest version, although it can be very nostalgic, looking back. Suppose we'll have to make a decision nearer to the time. Right, this is our field of choice for today. Let's get it unfolded. Get it done. Again, the equipment is probably too big for the field, but it doesn't really matter. Just got to be careful going around the headland the first time. Now, try not to miss anything too considerable. How is the sound for everyone? Is it okay? Because usually, well, I tend to adjust the sound from episode to episode to try and fine tune it. Because getting the perfect match between the game sound and the narration over the top or the commentary, it can be very hard actually. With a field like this, it can be quite tight, so I think what I might do is just keep going up and down the field once we have completed this second headland. It's quite a tricky shape, really. I suppose in real life you'd be using smaller equipment than this. This doesn't really require a double rake. We could just have a single one. That would make a lot more sense. It's nice to have the bigger equipment, but it's not always practical. Right, let's see. Get around the corner. Yeah, just about. Sort of taking two into one. Right, so we're almost there. I have to keep lifting it up because otherwise we're going to be putting a lot of strain on the PTO, turning it off all the time. Thing is, you can sort of flick what you've already done across the field if you catch it, like I did then. Tiny bit left here. And yeah, small section will be done, which is a good thing because I'm looking forward to doing the baling. And with this field, we shouldn't lose any. They shouldn't roll away. Fantastic. Right, fold it up. We'll take this away. It doesn't need to be here anymore. I'll try not to drive over what we've just done. Too much. We'll have to go over it a bit. There we go. So yes, this is the best yard to keep the windrow at. We don't really want to have it at the other yard. Most of the grass work is around here anyway. It's just finding the space for them. All these different pieces of equipment. We have got next to no space here. There is probably more space around the other side. But this will probably stay on the tractor. Will that fit in there? Nope, don't think it will do. But that's okay. We'll turn it off here. And we'll get back into the case. Oh, look at that. The exhaust seems to be wobbling quite a bit. Must be all the cab suspension we've got on here. We don't need the lights on, we're just sort of showing off. So we'll switch them off. Right, baler, here we are. I do need to invest in a square baler, but as this has sort of taken all of our money, it's not too easy. Let's go. Bit tricky getting out of here. There we go. Field 77. We might silage bale it because we've already done the other method and you can't have too much of it. Look at that. That looks so good. I didn't used to like Case really, but I love this tractor. Let's put this down. There we go. It begins. Yes, I think we probably will wrap it. We could even do it today, or at least make a start. That was easy. Already full. Although, the yield doesn't seem to be too good for some reason. I love the way they've animated the bonnet moving. Just like in real life. How the bonnet sort of rattles a bit, the cab moves it independently from the rest of it. Clearly, a lot of work has been put into it. The yield is okay. It's not amazingly good, but I've seen worse, definitely seen worse. It could be because the soil mod reappeared temporarily. That might have messed it up a bit. Which is, it'd be a shame if that is the reason. Or it could just be the way it is. Maybe that's just how the hay is in this game. We've so far had two bales out of it. But the power of this tractor, it's immense. You can just accelerate like there's nothing on the back. Really, really good. Okay, bale number three. It somehow seems easier to bale with this tractor as well. It's probably just psychological, but yeah, it seems harder to miss stuff. beacons are the same, as you would expect. But yeah, love it. Like I say, download link is below. We are almost done. What's the next bale? Bale number four? Looks like it's going to be four, we'll have enough for five, but still, four bales out of this field. I suppose if it was real life, that wouldn't be very good, but for Farming Simulator, yeah, that's okay. I mean, we don't need that many bales anyway. Yes, it's nice to sell them, but I don't really want to have my hands full with too many bales. Just realise that the wheel weights are still on. We do not need the wheel weights, definitely not. Which one was it? This one, just here. There we go. Yeah, we don't need to have unnecessary compaction. When I start to say stuff like that, some people just say, you're taking it too far, don't be so realistic. I think, I kind of agree, yeah. I won't go too far. But it would be good if you could have like compaction in your field. FS17 is sort of taking that into account, because every few times that you harvest stuff, you have to plough. You can turn that option off, but yeah, ploughing is a necessity in Farming Simulator 17. Okay, moving on to the next type. This is going to be wrapped, so we need to activate wrapping by pressing Z. And this is a much bigger field, as you can see, but a much easier field because it's so much bigger. So this one should start to be wrapped on its own, hopefully. Yes, it will. Good. Fantastic. So that's working well. I'm looking forward to seeing a fully wrapped bale field. Missing a few bits here. As soon as you get onto the turning, that is when you miss bits. And this is very high yielding. I can see why though. We use the chrome Big M. Right, off you go. Next bale. Wait for it to come out the back. Go. Right, let's continue. Yes, this may take a while because we've got to wait every time for it to finish wrapping the previous bale. And you can see how quickly the bale chamber is being filled up. Already full again. So, yeah. This is going to be productive. Wow, I think I've got my work cut out here. If it was a square baler, obviously it'd be so quick because it would just fire them all out the back, but because it's a round baler, we have to stop for it to unload the bale chamber. But also, it's having to wrap them as well, so it's like a delay. We have one ready, but the wrapped bale is still being wrapped. So, yeah, this is a big job. How many have we got so far? Quite a few. Oh, still another bale coming. At least the bales aren't rolling away, because that would be causing havoc. Okay, a few bales on. We're still going strong though. The only issue is, because we use the chrome Big N, the swath is so wide that it is very, very easy to miss bits, and I don't think the pickup is actually wide enough to do that. So, yeah, I don't know what the solution to that would be, because surely every baler is the same, I'm not too sure. Next bale coming out now, there we go. Start the wrapping process and we'll start the next bale. so I should be able to start going up and down the field now. Of course, picking up as much as we can do. Got to stay relatively central. But we'll be done before it's dark, at least. Having said all that, actually, it is a lot easier to do this on the straight. Finding it a lot easier to get it all in the pickup, as long as you don't set off before it's unloaded to bail out the bail chamber. Yes, it's on the corners. On the corners it is very, very difficult. I think you have to do it on two passes. What I propose that we do is we do a time lapse of this. It's going to be the best way of portraying it in a good way. And then I'll speed it all up, obviously. That is a time lapse. Yes. And no, don't do that. And then, yes, it should be a lot better. I'm hoping that it'll be a lot more enjoyable watching it at speed than it will be at this speed. Because if we were to do all this field like this in real time, we'll probably be here, let's just see, Christmas time? Yeah, about that. So, yeah. See you soon. Okay, so we're pretty much done. Just stop the time lapse there. We've still got a tiny bit left to do. I've got a few bits to clear up. But you can see what I have missed, and really, it's not too much. There is a bit. I'm not too worried about it. You could probably collect all of that stuff and make another bale, which would be roughly £6,500. But really, for the effort that's required to do that, it wouldn't really be worth it. I'll get this bit here though. This bit here is definitely worth it. There we go. And yeah, we'll swing up here, get this bit, and then turn left, get that bit over there. And there's a bit down the bottom end, which I've missed as well. So obviously the big areas we'll get, but the not so significant areas we'll leave. But it does look good. I always like the look of a field full of rat bales. I was going to say a bale full of fields, yeah. That would be something. So we've got this bit just here. Get this bit picked up. And there is a bit just over there as well. And this should produce the final bale. With a bit of luck. Yep, definitely. We're going to need 15% more, so that is absolutely fine. And then whatever's left in the baler can be used next time. Oh, that's going to be so close. Look at that. We've got like this tiny bit left here. We better pick it up though. Otherwise it'll look very scruffy. there we go. So, yes, first day using the Case Optum. Love it. Really good tractor. I look forward to using it again. And there is the final bale. So, what did it turn out to be? Was it 36 or 37? I think it was 36, yeah. So, not too bad at all. All we need to do now is take this back to the yard, and we're going to call it a day. But I look forward to using it again in the future. It's going to be pretty decent. Any high horsepower requiring jobs, it would be perfect for. Getting into tight spaces, however, not perfect at all. Here we are. We're back home. So all we need to do is put it in the shed here, and then until next time, that will be it. Time really does fly when you're having fun. But I'm still pleased with my decision. I wouldn't have really wanted to get rid of the John Deere. It's just, it was money really. We've only got £7,000 now, so it was required really to sell another tractor. But it's okay, it's okay. We'll live. We'll pull through this financial crisis. So there we go. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye for now.